89th and 3rd, please.
Almighty, all right. How you doing, my friend?
I'm all right, man.
All right, great. And they make a good hot dog at that place, Papaya King.
Yeah.
You know, it's grilled, you know? It's not like that boiled crap you get on the streets, you know? You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying, man.
You know, boiled stuff, you bite into it and pop, you know, boiling water into the mouth, you know the deal. Squirts in your face sometimes, too. But at Papaya King, that's really good quality food.
Yeah, I know, man. It's great. You know, it's crazy that my friends or the guys I work with, they wouldn't go near a place like that.
Yeah. Say, what do you do for a living? I mean, like for an occupation, you know what I mean?
Well, I'm a stockbroker on Wall Street. I write a little bit on the side.
Oh, yeah? Now, there's something I wouldn't mind doing too much, you know, doing a little bit of writing. Yeah. Anyway, hey, tell me, what the hell, Paytel, do you write about?
Just from experience, you know, things, everyday life.
Everyday life? Boy, that sure is a roller coaster.
You said it.
You know, it's like with my landlord, exactly. You know, I live, Jersey, get out of my way. I live in Long Island City, you know, where it's going to turn over. You know what I'm saying? The rents?
Gentrification.
Yeah, gentrification. And, you know, the landlord, you know, rents are going up. He's not going to give me a new lease.
No way.
But, you know, I got a paralegal buddy. He says, you know, they can't legally kick you out, you know. So, you know, landlords, they'll screw you first chance again, you know. Oh. They live to screw you, you know, landlords.
Yeah, right. But you know what's funny?
Sure. I was thinking, you know, can you imagine a young kid that wants to grow up and be a landlord? You know, think about that. You know, it's awful strange. I got a weird mind. You know, I don't need much money, you know. A cabin is just fine with me, you know, because you meet a lot of people. And you know what? You meet a lot of women.
I'll tell you that.
Almost 50% of the time you turn around, and there's a woman there, you know. It's an ideal situation, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm living with one woman right now. She's an ex-prostitute, you know what I'm saying, you know.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Because
it's a good deal because, you know.
They're there.
Women are wild, you know what I'm saying? And her pimp, he was bad news. You know, he used to rough her up pretty badly, you know, the program. So, you know, my buddy and me, we kidnapped her, you know. I'll tell you, it was quite a scene. She was kicking and screaming and so forth. Still under the psychological control of the pimp, you know. We had trouble getting her into the van. Anyway, I'd love to have been a fly on the wall the next day when the pimp comes in. You know why.
Well, yeah, because he would...
Where's my prostitute? You know? I mean, the guy's got to be kicking himself, wondering, you know, whose head is he going to split like a peanut, you know? I mean, I was even going to go back later, you know, roughhouse, but I figured, you know, you get a girl on your arm and you're not paying for her, you know, you're not thinking about killing somebody, am I right?
No.
I'm right, yeah. Anyway, you know, she was screwed up pretty bad, you know, drugs, the whole scoop. So I took her to all these methadone clinics, you know, Phoenix, Arizona House, the best, first class, all the way. You know, you're a writer. We can talk about this.
Okay.
They got all these waiting lists, you know, you come back in 3 months, you know, but we found that, you know, this Reality House, it's called, 125th Street Lenox, Reality House. You need to go there. I mean, they took her and cleaned her up. No questions asked. That's your place, I'm telling you. That's your place. All right, I think we're here. 8093?
Yeah, it's the last house on the left with the doorman.
All right then, my friend. Great. Well, good luck to you, my friend. I certainly enjoyed our little tete-a-tete.
Yeah, I have too. Listen, just keep the change, okay?
Yeah, thank you. Say, thank you. Hey, hold on. Wait a second. Now, you're a writer. I mean, you didn't tell me what you're working on, you know? I mean, I can't leave yet. What are you working on?
Well, it's just this novel, and it's about this tightly knit New England family who really love each other, and they have trouble physicalizing and vocalizing, you know, their feelings for one another. And there's this hotel fire on their vacation, and the parents get lost, and they end up eating their children to stay alive. It's a real mess.
Whoa! Whoa, now that's a wild one.
Yeah.
That's weird. I mean, I don't know how, I just don't know how you writers do it. I mean, you come up with this stuff. It's just, I mean, that's really something what you people do.
Yeah. It's just everyday life, you know? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Okay, man.
Ooh, yeah. I mean,
okay, man.
All right, thank you. Ooh. Wow. Well, it's sad what it is, this everyday life. I mean, the people that have to, you know, live this everyday life. I mean, that is sad.